Okay, Chris, here we are flying down that tunnel that connects the middeck to the Spacehab, and here we are in the orbiter docking system, the ODS, where tomorrow Bill and Valeri will greet each other up at that hatch right there, and as you can see, the docking camera has been installed. The various bags of equipment have been removed from the ODS. The tunnel continues about another 10 to 12 feet to the Spacehab, which is a marvelous logistics carrier for us. The front half is dedicated about half to science and engineering and half to logistics, while the back half, the new double module half, is dedicated entirely to transfer items and items to come back to Mir. Here, Carl is examining some of the active rack isolation system messages that have come up in the last few days. We continue on through the center of the Spacehab into the aft section, seeing some of the numerous hard lockers and soft stowage bags, as well as on the left, a big blue refrigerator to carry up and down samples of biological materials to the Russian space station Mir. On this side is a gyroscope, a gyrodyne as they call it, which is used to help stabilize Mir. We're taking it up to replace one that's failed aboard Mir. You see some of the voluminous storage space we have there. Coming back to the front half is a rack called the Extreme Temperature Translation Furnace, which is running right now to process samples. Gets up to 1,650 degrees centigrade. There's Carl in front of the ARIS rack on the right. And here's another shot of the ARIS rack, the active rack isolation system, or soft ride kind of suspension system that will provide an increase of a factor of 10 to 100 in microgravity. Over to the left, back in a corner, is an experiment called the Mechanics of Granular Materials that we're just now starting to activate. That will simulate the squashing of materials that happens in a silo or a hopper, help understand how those materials flow under load, as in during an earthquake. Up front is our PGSC with a world map, so we got all the comforts of home. There's the communications panel that we talked to you on. Coming back down, looking at the long tunnel into the orbiter, we fly up through the section of the tunnel, which is just a very nice piece of gear. You can get yourself going in one straight line and then not touch the walls all the way until you get into the orbiter airlock that's filled with all the water bags that Terry Wilcutt's been filling for transfer to Mir. So it's really like the cargo hold of a big ship, and an expedition ship that's taken an explorer, John Blaha, through this hatch down to Antarctica in the time a century ago, but now we're going to be taking John up to the space station Mir, and we have quite a lot of logistics supplies for him up there. So that's a tour of our supply ship, and back to you, Bill. I'm sorry, to Chris.
Thanks, Jay. Nice tour.
This is Mission Control Houston on the flight deck of Atlantis. Pilot Terry Wilcutt, Mission Specialist Jay Apton, Commander Bill Readdy. Now just about 2 minutes away from that small phasing burn to refine Atlantis's approach to the Mir space station.
Atlantis Houston, good burn, no trim required.
Rescue me, I want your tender charm, 'cause I'm alone. Atlantis Houston with a message from Shannon. Good morning.
Well, we had two problems. One that occurred late in the countdown, that was a fuel cell alarm for PH. That's as a result of having changed out and having a new fuel cell in position two. That's working just fine right now, and that's no factor. Right after we got main engine cutoff, we had APU-2 underspeed, but that's really not a factor for our on-orbit operation, so we're expecting to have no impact to our rendezvous and docking with the Mir.
Well, I can tell you that both Shannon and I started this project together. We went off to language school, went to Star City about a year and a half ago together, have been taking a lot of classes together. She left me and Marks to go to Mir, and I look forward to replacing her. I think she's ready to leave, but I'm ready to get there and get on to working with the Russians.
Can you tell us the importance of these missions in terms of cooperation with the Russians?
Well, obviously, it's very important. The road to this was kicked off many, many years ago with the Apollo-Soyuz program, but that was only a one-off mission. We're building the bridge to the International Space Station right now, and in fact, we're operating the International Space Station right now with John's presence, Shannon's presence, Norm Thagard's presence aboard the Mir station. So it's vital that we learn to support the logistics, the science, and the human experiments that go on board.
Well, that's a pretty big question. Of course, we're taking about 65 experiments that we're going to be doing on the next phase here. Probably the most exciting one is a bioreactor, and there we'll be doing a cartilage in space experiment. This particular one is growing cartilage of cows' knees. We'll try to verify the process. This, of course, has tremendous potential for future medicine with growing different parts of human tissue in orbit. Dave Wolf, an astronaut who I flew with 3 years ago in orbit, developed the bioreactor, so I know he's very excited about the results of this experiment.
Spicy food items like onions and garlic and hot sauce, what is that all about?
We had a chance to train with the cosmonauts this past April when they were over here, and we asked them, you know, what they would like for us to bring up when we come, and they said, you know, after you've been up there a while, you really like the taste of something that's different than what they've got on board, and of course, fresh food items like that don't last very long, so, and of course, even we astronauts, when we're up here, we like things just a little bit spicier and tangier than we do down on Earth.
No, I'm not. You know, at Star City, we got a lot of training from the Russians, psychological training for long-duration space flight. We also have a lot of protocols on board where we do exercise twice daily. Then we do a lot of health monitoring. And with all of those protocols, you can keep track of your status and if you need to change your exercise protocols so as to minimize the types of things you just talked about. And the experience that the Russians have had certainly shows that it's an individual thing as to your recovery process. It depends on you as a human being and your ability to have time to do those exercise protocols in orbit.
Colonel Akers, this is the fourth docking with Mir. Is the docking procedure old hat by now, or is this still sort of a white-knuckle procedure for everyone involved?
Well, we've had a lot of time in the simulators, and we're pretty confident that the ground team is well prepared, and our training team has worked real hard getting us prepared. So we're not overconfident, but we're sure that this is something that's going to go off very well, and we're sure anxious to see Shannon looking out window and mirror.
Atlantis Houston, we're with you in the Spacehab. Mile of video.
Okay, and how's the TV quality?
No change.
We copy.
And Atlantis Spacehab, while you're checking, we're with you on video in the HAP.
Okay, super.
Go ahead, Carl.
Yeah, Bill, do you still have a video in Spacehab?
Yes, sir, we do, and the color's still faded out.
I got a message from my wife. It's still our anniversary, so I just I don't know if you can read that or not, but it says, "Happy anniversary, Pam." Number 20, and it's from me, so just wanted to wish her a great anniversary, tell her I'm having fun.
We copy, Carl. Carl, why don't you try to bring that up a little closer to the lens, and, of course, congratulations to the two of you from all of us down here. Hey, that's great. We got a good shot now.
Thanks, Bill. John, I've reviewed message 27, the BTS update. Both copies in English are good. The copy in Russian is good. Please pass along to all the people that worked on updating these procedures, especially Ursula. Thanks a lot. As a result, we'll probably pull it off very good.
And thanks, John. We'll pass that on.